So good morning, everybody, and welcome to this session, Getting Started with Intelligent Cars. This is an event that we're doing along with Intel, and it promises to be a very exciting session, specifically looking at computer vision for intelligent cars and a lot of kind of real world examples that have come up. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for joining this session today. Unfortunately, the previous time we had to cancel it because of some unforeseen circumstances, but we're glad that a lot of you could come back and join us today. For those of you who are coming to an Applied Singularity event for the first time, my name is Nihal Kashinath. I'm the founder of Applied Singularity. And Applied Singularity is basically a platform for those who are interested in Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, and bioengineering. We do have an app of our own. Please do download it from the Play Store or from the App Store. It's a free download. And what it does is it gives you access to the latest that is happening in the space, whether it is news, whether it is events, workshops, courses, research papers, jobs, and a whole bunch of resources that you would need in your journey towards proficiency in frontier tech. So with that, we will get started off with today's event. Like I said, it's a very exciting space. There's so many things that are happening in this area of intelligent cars and self-driving vehicles, all of those. And so today we're going to get a very nice introduction to all of this. We will also get a quick walkthrough of OpenMINO, which is a toolkit specifically for computer vision from Intel. And for those of you who have registered for this event on the event site, not Meetup, but the Intel site, you will also have access to Intel's Dev Cloud for the Edge, which is a very powerful platform for you to build and prototype your computer vision applications and modules. So we have here with us today Dr. Sriram. He is an expert in machine learning. He is an Intel innovator himself, and he is a prolific researcher. He's published more than 100 plus papers in various journals. Sriram is also a mentor to a lot of startups and students. So those of you who are interested, please feel free to reach out to him after this session. And you can always reach out to him with any questions. So we're very happy to have Sriram here with us today. And we're really looking forward to this talk. Sriram, over to you.
Right. Good morning, everybody. And it's very nice to meet you guys all. Thank you very much, Nihal, for the introduction, and this is a great platform where we can interact with people. And we are getting into the session right away without wasting much time. I have seen the way the AI has grown tremendously from nowhere to here. So everything is AI now. Wherever we go from, we are seeing AI. And it starts from the simplest of applications to the most complex applications in medical, healthcare, automobile engineering. The AI has been growing tremendously. So it's needless to say that we need to learn that, and we have got a lot of working space that is available in the AI domain. And today I'm going to show you some of the quickest of the applications that I have built with my team, and they're all pretty good to go with as a beginner or as an engineer who wants to learn AI or as a person who wants to get into AI. That's how we started it. Intelligent cars. So it's one area that never really bores us. So whenever we work with automobile or drones or healthcare, I never get bored with, and I work with all three domains consistently. And I publish papers, or all my startups that I have worked on are all on this domain. And we do a little bit of IoT as well. So if you have any queries, clarifications in terms of IoT or in terms of these, I can really help you out. Now, to start with, let's go ahead with one by one of the applications that we have developed, starting from the very simplest of stuff to the most complex stuff. I'm going to take you through. I've got the demo videos ready, and I'm going to give you a complete clear picture of how do we build it. Very simple. I'll start with the simplest one. If you see the high-end cars, take on Audi or BMW or for that matter, even CS, the cars which are above 10 lakhs or 12 lakhs in India, if you see, they're all having most of the sophisticated features which are comfort plus safety. I feel that comfort can come at a cost, but safety should not come at a cost. Safety should be for everybody. The driver assist system or the driver monitoring system should be available for everybody, and they should be made available to each and every one of us, irrespective of you having a Maruti 800 or I having an Audi. It doesn't matter. So we should have the safety features for everybody. That's the motto I started working on ADAS and DMS systems. And most of them are pretty successful, and we are now deploying it also in a few of our cars that we have at the university, as well as we are talking to somebody to implement it real time at a very lower cost. That's the most important point. To start with, I'm going to take you through one of the simplest of the products that we have built towards ADAS, and I'm going to take you through step by step. If you cannot understand anything, it's all self-explanatory indeed. If you cannot understand anything, let me know. I'll be able to clarify that. And if you have any questions in between, I'd like you to make a note of the questions and type it in the chat box so that I can really come over the questions and I can answer them at the end of the session. And I wish I answer all the questions. And in case I cannot answer at this moment for some reasons, I'll come back to you through your email ID or whatever medium you have. I can help you out with the answer. We start with a simple driver monitoring system that I'm going to show you right now. What is it? Very simple. I need to understand if I am the authorized driver to start my vehicle. This is the first point. Okay, how do you do that? Simple, use machine learning. I train my face. I train the faces of the drivers who are all going to be permitted or to be authenticated towards using that vehicle. And I'm going to do that. And if anybody else comes in, I'll peep an alarm. I'll pop up an alarm immediately and the vehicle will not be started. This is the first point. Second point, the driver can wear a spectacle, the driver can wear a cap, the driver can turn here and there while driving. In spite of that, we should be able to recognize him properly. That's the next point that we need to understand. And above that, what else can we do in the same setup? We need to monitor the number of people who are sitting in the car or the vehicle for that matter. For example, if we deploy the system for the school vans, naturally they should not have more people dumped into the vehicle. So if we have more count, we can alert. So I'm counting the number of people inside the vehicle all time. And the next thing, next very important thing, we should not allow child to sit in the front row of the car as the driver. It's prohibited in most of the countries. Wherever I travel, I have seen that the children are not allowed to sit in the first row because in case of an accident, the impact would be pretty high for the children who are sitting in the first row. So that's naturally avoided. So here in our country, if you see, even my son, if he is not given the first seat, he won't come to the car. So that's the way we are encouraging our children to sit in the first row, which is not correct actually. So we need to avoid that as well. So we have implemented all these in a very simple setup. Followed by that, we are able to recognize even the driver's behavior. I'll talk about it a little later. For now, we will start with a very simple driver monitoring or driver recognition system, which is going to be very helpful for all of us. And this is all implemented without spending much money. We are using NVIDIA Jetson board. We are using a very simple piece of OpenVINO code or normal machine learning code, which I'll talk about a little later when I come to the next level where I can talk about OpenVINO. So all these are really simple. Sir, is this really simple, sir? Yes, it is simple. I started learning it 1.5 years back and now we could build applications. So if you are thinking about developing applications in machine learning and deep learning, I think this is the best time that you can start with and it's going to be very easy. Let's go ahead with the very simple demo where I have built a very efficient, very easy to use driver monitoring system. I hope you can listen to me and am I audible, all of you? Can one of you confirm it in the chat box, if you can? Am I audible? Could you see the screen?
Can yes, you see the screen? We can see you and we can hear you. Sir.
Right, perfect. Thank you very much. I hope it's clear. Right, we'll go with the demo right now. See to that. And all these demos, whatever I have built, I'm building it towards productizing as well as I participate in a lot of hackathons all over the world. And I have won about 50 plus hackathons all over. So we build systems based on the problem statements that are thrown by the company. So that's how we can start learning. Sir, where do I start, sir? How do I start learning? You can start learning from the hackathon websites where they'll exactly tell you what is the need for the hour. That's how you get problem statements. You need to really look into the hacks to understand what do they need? Because that's how things grow faster and you can really get a lot of content there. Let's play the thing without wasting much of time. Hello, we have built a driver monitoring system, which is fundamentally based on camera like any other driver monitoring system. Normally, DMS is expected to provide a real-time evaluation of the presence and the state of driver. And that's what we do as well. We are going to monitor the status of the driver in certain aspects. For example, I'm going to first identify whom the driver is based on the pre-trained system. We can allow only certain people to drive our vehicle and we train our system with the database, with the images of those people who are allowed to drive our vehicle. So the first stage is to identify who is the driver. The driver identification is done. Second part is how many people are sitting in the car is to be evaluated because we cannot have more than 4 people in a 4-seater car or more than 5 people in a 5-seater car. And the next very important thing is allowing children in the front row of the car. It is prohibited in many countries and it is not allowed. In case of an accident, the children will get impacted very highly and that's to be avoided. So we are also tracking if children are sitting in the front row and be given alert in case it happens. And the overload alert is also given. For example, in a four-seated car, if there are five people, we pop up an alert saying that this is overload. And now the driver, if he turns his head and shows only his head, if it is full of hair or if he is bald, we cannot recognize the driver, and we have tested it as well. And the most important point, the driver can wear a spectacle or a coolers, we could still recognize it. The driver can wear a headphone or he can wear a headgear like cap. We tested it as well. I'm going to show you all this step by step, and I hope you understand how the system works. Now, if you see that in the screen, we have got the status and the system is launched. You can see that train model, test model, retrain, remove directory, and the exit options are there. First, we are removing all the available pre-trained data so that we can start from the scratch. Now you can see that I'm going to press the option one. So once the option one is pressed, you are ready to train the system. I'm going to enter the ID and name is Ash. Now the training is going to start here. You can see that the person sitting in the right or left can be captured based on the driving system. If you are an Indian system, you will have to go with the right. Similarly, a left driving is also allowed. We can set up our system based on the requirement. Now the training has to happen, and we need to take about 10 to 15 images at least, and the frame capturing happens right now, as you could see in front of you. It is about 10 frames that is sufficient for me to completely get the system ready, but more the images is going to get you better the results. That's a natural phenomena that everybody follows. But for the want of time, we stop it at say around 15 to 20 images, and that is sufficient for us. The training happens, and all these are real time. And how many ever drivers you can, I mean, if you want to allow five drivers in your system to drive the car, I need to train the system with five. So other people will be automatically recognized, and it's a problem there, we will give an alert. Now we are going to test the model, and entry of two is sufficient for us. So automatically that testing will start right now. Now you can see that it's recognized as Ash because the driver that we trained is Ash, and the moment he moves out, it was also recognized properly. You can see that now it is recognized as male and not a child. Driver name is Ash and number of people is one. All these details, number of children is zero. Now when he puts his heads down, when the driver put his heads down, the hair is only seen there, so it cannot understand. And though that's a problem. So if hair is too much, also the system is having some problem. But once he's shown properly, that's all determined properly. So now you can see that I'm showing a face of a child through a mobile phone. I did not have a kid near me, so we tested it this way by showing a photo, and you can say that it's very difficult to classify a kid as a male or a female when it is an infant. That's the problem that we face as well, but you can see that it's classified as child most of the time. You can see that when it is closer, it's getting classified because of the shake of the camera. We could find some discrepancies there, but still is fine. And you got an alert message saying children not allowed in the front seats right in the beginning over there, and that's a very important feature. So the next thing to be included is to test the driver with different accessories like spectacles with earphones kind of stuff. So we are going to do that right now so that you can easily understand our system stability at multiple scenarios. Now, you'll see that right now. You can see that the system is also performing quite well and quite real time. There is no delay, and most importantly, the results are also obtained real time in the background. You could see that. So now I'm going to show a lot of people. I have got a photograph where we've got a lot of people and the passenger limit is exceeded. All the male females are identified properly and we got an alert as passenger limit exceeded. So that's a very important point. Now we are going to go with one more scenario. So I'm going to test the model again, but with one more scenario, as I told you, with spectacles. And you can see that it's still nicely recognizing as Ash. That's it. It's a very simple setup and it's at a very initial stage, but still this is a very vital system, I believe. And we are going to go with more training content into it, like we are going to train for multiple ethnicity, multiple races also we are going to take up. Now you can see that we have trained the system with the cap as well, and it's recognizing nicely with cap. So all these are done real time and there is no delay at all. And that's the most appreciable feature that you need to really note into. And that's all. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you understood the very preliminary content out here. This is a very preliminary stage which we have done. Now what we are going to do is we are going to go through the next level. Can I monitor the driver's behavior? Can I understand if the driver is drinking or smoking or using mobile phone Can I see if driver is getting deviated from his job? Yes, we can do that, and we have done that as well. And this comes with extensive training. The only thing that you need to learn when you go ahead with machine learning or deep learning every time is you need to train. It's all complete training and nothing else. You got to train, train, train until you get the success. I'm going to show you this module where you'll be able to clearly understand how exactly the system recognizes the driver's behavior. Last time we monitored the driver for identification. This time we are monitoring the driver for his behavior. So totally, this all come under DMS driver monitoring system. Hello, we have come up with the next module for our driver monitoring system. It's a very efficient and easy to use system. This time we have gone a little high in the functionalities. I'll explain you one by one by showing you the demo. First, the drivers are not supposed to use phone while they are driving. So we should detect the phone and we should get an alert like what you are getting in the screen right now. You can see that the phone is detected perfectly and you get an alert, do not use phone while driving, right on the top. This can be added with the audio alert as well, saying that drivers, please do not use phone while driving for your safety and others' safety. This is the first module that we have added to our DMS. The next one is the drinking and driving habit. The drunken drive is the most dangerous habit that we have while driving, and we are supposed to detect it. And now you can see that I have shown a Bacardi bottle here and it is getting detected. I have earlier shown a normal bottle and that's also detected, and we got a message flashed on the screen. Now I'm going to use cigar, and this is not a cigar, by the way, this is like that with the paper, and it is getting detected. We got a message flashed on the screen, do not smoke and drive. So all these are implemented real time and it will work perfectly and precisely as you have seen. This is a very simple yet innovative deep learning based approach for us to get the driver behavior clearly tracked and to alert in case of a deviation. Thank you. I hope you understood the way it has been done. It's all very simple, and again, it's very easy to do. Well, so what is the next level? We need not just monitor the driver, but we need to also assist the drivers. So that's the next level. That's how the system should be functioning. So what are you going to do, sir? Very simple. I'm going to launch a system which will help the drivers in driving appropriately while detecting the lane changes, while doing all those things properly, and it's all completely real time. But the biggest challenge is I have taken the data set from US. While I was there last time, I have shot a lot of data. I mean, it's all complete video, as you can understand, and we have taken a lot of video there. So it's about 2 GB, 2.5 GB of video that I have in the US roads. It is very easy to process because the rules and regulations are followed most of the time, and a very limited amount of deviations are found. But now, in Indian conditions, can we try this out? We have tried that out as well, which I'm going to show you a little later. But for now, first, let's go with the Western data set, which is very easy to handle, and it's no difficult. In fact, it was a cakewalk for us to implement it and to get the better results, but it was very challenging for us to do the same with Indian data set. Hello, friends. We have developed something very new, and it's going to be very interesting for you. I'm going to show you the ADAS system, driver assisting system, which is going to help the drivers in finding if they are going to collide with the cars that are going in front. It is called forward collision detection. We are going to do that. And also, we are detecting if there is a lane change which is happening and another car is going to come into your lane real time, and we will alert you. If you are going very close to the previous car, I mean the car just before you, we will give you a message like you are dangerously close to them. But otherwise, we'll keep monitoring and we'll give you all the output real time. This is a beautiful attempt, and I'm going to show you the results right now, and you will be able to appreciate it once you see it, I believe. Let's go ahead with the demo. I'm launching it right now, and it will take half a minute for me to just set up the system, and it's a real-time video feed that we have taken, and we have pushed it onto the system that we have built. You can see that in the left-hand side corner, right-hand side, all are the processing, and we have processed that way, and the left corner here, you can see that we get the distance very clearly notified. And when I'm going very close, you can see that it will be giving us an alert. This is not dangerously close. It's close, but when you go dangerously close, you'll get an alert. You can see that now, dangerous. the message has come. So this will help the drivers in understanding that is it a safe distance to follow the car that is just before you and ahead of you, and they can take decisions accordingly. You can see that the cars coming in the opposite directions are also measured in such a quick time frame. Now it is dangerously very close. And we have also been able to detect the lane change, which you will see right now in a few seconds time frame. And all these feed are analyzed real time, and you can see the edges which are detected, and this has a lot of computation inside. And this feature is available in many modern and high-end cars, but not with the low-end cars. Now, when you go closer, we get the alert every time, real time. We can also have a voice over there saying that don't go close, stay away kind of alert can be given for the drivers to be safeguarded. You can see that now we are going to have a lane change detection right now happening that will be also detected quickly. And you can see that the car on the left-hand side, lane change. It's detected. So it's also detected very quickly, and it's absolutely real time. And one thing that is required in all these real time systems is it has to be a really real time. And we could get that here and hope you liked it. Thank you. Right. So what next? This is done, sir. So what next? We have got multiple modules to be implemented. And when we are driving, particularly in the Indian conditions, as I told you, is not easy. It's really very challenging. So Indian conditions, in fact, we took a lot of time for training because every city has got its own way of driving. It's not a common rule that we follow here. If you go to Chennai, the people drive in a way. If you go to Delhi, the people drive in a different way. So it's all pretty challenging for us to really get all the data set into our system and all the functioning happening properly. I could still say that we have got 90% accuracy and not 100%. It's not easy. So I'm going to show you the way we have clearly determined how exactly the Indian data set is being handled by our system, which is developed. I hope you definitely like it. Welcome back. In the previous ADAS demo that I have shown you, I mean the advanced driver assisting system demo that I have shown you, we have used the Western countries data set where it was very clean and the traffic rules were obeyed perfectly and no intrusion in between, no two-wheeler came in between. All this were very easy for us to, in fact, do it for the forward collision warning system. Now, what if the same thing has been done for systems where there are intruders in between coming in two-wheelers, or the traffic system is not very highly formulated properly or obeyed properly? That is, if we go with any Asian countries, most of the Asian countries have this traffic congestion systems, and we need to analyze that, and our system should be capable of working in that condition. That's what we have done right now, and I'm going to show you the demo of it right now, and you can see that. Now, this is the typical Indian condition where you could see that it's only two lanes available, and everything is getting detected properly, and this is done with the Jetson board, NVIDIA Jetson board, and you can see that the three mosquitoes came in. So it's very tough to detect this, and we have done this through extensive training, and it came through a lot of effort, and you can see that everything is getting detected properly, and you got an alert. You can see that danger go slow is coming properly, and I'm going to take through multiple Indian scenarios like this, and you can see the next one right now in front of you in a couple of seconds. You can see that here we are taking the scenario where it is only one lane, but we are trying to overtake, and that is a very risky scenario, and we are alerting as danger, slow down. And this is a typical road in Chennai area, and we have taken that video feed, and you can see that the alert is coming for the two-wheelers which are coming in between, and all these are real time. You can see that everything is real time, and the ones which are coming in the opposite directions are detected, but we won't get any alert for it unless and until it is in the same lane as you travel. We do not pop up any alert. And this is yet another region which is very congested again. And see the way the two-wheeler guy is going. That's all properly detected, and we are getting alert messages, slow down for this. And we are going to go with one more demo right now, which will help you understand how exactly our system is fully functional. It is all easy. Only thing that you need to do is you need to go with a lot of testing again and again and training, and only then you could get this done. And you can see that this is a highway where there are three lanes, and in fact, yeah, four lanes are available. We could detect that properly, and there was an animal in between. Now the night vision. So for the night vision also, it is getting detected nicely, and everything is real time, and it has to be real time. In fact, otherwise the system is a failure. You could see that we are getting the alert for the night drive as well. So all these are done and implemented and fully working right now. I am very happy to show you this, and I hope you liked it. If you have any questions, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be happily answering it. Thank you very much. Right. So we have done this, and what next? I have shown you the ADAS system. I have shown you the DMS system. We have got some more things which are left out, which I'm going to discuss, and it's all going to be demo. And only when you start trying it out, you could get a complete feel of how things work. So if you need any help in between, let me know. I'll happily do it. And it's in fact a pleasure working with you people. Right. What next? It's very simple. What we're going to do is I'm going to now detect if there is a collision opportunity, collision chance that's going to come with a car that is going to be driven in front of us. What do you mean, sir? Very simple. I'm going very closer. So can I get somebody telling me that don't go close, caution? So this caution can be coming as a virtual bumper. So we have implemented a virtual bumper, which is going to be very helpful for you in terms of definitely presenting you an alert. Also, in signals, you must have definitely seen this. I'm putting my car in signal because I'm halting my car in signal because it's a red signal. And I'll start seeing the right-hand side, left-hand side like this, and I'll get deviated slightly. This is nature, and every one of us will do that. But when the signal changes, immediately the next guy will start honking, and that's a pain. So instead, if somebody tells you the signal has changed, start moving. The car just above you, the car just ahead of you starts moving, please move. If somebody alerts you like that, it will be good, right? That's the kind of assistance that we need. And that's what we have done. We have built a system where you will get a clear alert from your system saying that the previous car has moved, you start moving. And it's like you getting a clear alert from the neighbor who is sitting with you. So it's going to be very useful for you. And we will see that feature right now. Just give me one second. Friends, welcome back. In the previous deep learning demos for ADAS and the DMS systems, we have shown you a lot of demos. Here, we are going to show you a different demo, which is going to help you with a virtual bumper being generated in front of you with a message saying, caution, if you are going to hit or if you are going to be dangerously close to the vehicle, which is just ahead of you. I'm going in a car. I see another car going ahead of me and I'm going very close to it. So we have set the threshold and we are able to detect that we might hit that vehicle and the danger message will pop up in terms of an icon, which is called a virtual bumper. I will show you the demo with which you can understand how exactly things work. Let me launch the system and let me run it for you to understand it. I have launched it. Now the green lines are coming. The distance is safe. So now when the green line gets changed, it is going to yellow and the caution message is coming. When it is dangerously close, I'll get a message caution permanently there. This could serve as a virtual bumper for the drivers who are driving and this could avoid damages. So what I mean to say is this will alert the driver by posting this. You can see that now it is a red in color when it is dangerously close. When it is all okay, we get green in color. When we are close, we get yellow. And when it is red, it is dangerous and it is dangerously close. So we get the message and caution is alerted. Also, the previous car, the car ahead of you, when it moves, you saw a message as car started alert. So that will let the driver know that the vehicle that is just ahead of you has moved. So this is an alert that can help him understand that the vehicle above him is moving. You can see that the car will start now and you will get an alert as car started, as I have shown sometime back. Let me go to it again so that you can see that and you can understand how exactly it has come. You can see that car started message is flashing right there. The car started. Now this will help the drivers in understanding that the previous vehicle have started at times if their attention span is lost. Also, we get this caution message which will help them to understand they are very close to the previous vehicle and that can avoid damages and accidents. I hope you liked it. In case of any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type into the comment section. I'll be able to answer it. Thank you very much for following the channel consistently. Right. So we have seen most of the components that I have built. All this have been shot as a demo for you to see it quickly without boring you. And it's half an hour that I have spent with you now. But approximately we spent about 3 months time to get all this built. So it is not easy. But at the same time, I'm telling you, nowadays, we have got a lot of data set available in open. And the AAAT data set for the automobiles, for the traffic and related stuff is really very good, which is supported by Intel fully. You can download it. Just go to Google and type AAAT data set for roads. You will be able to get it. And that's one of the prominent data sets that we can use for Indian conditions. But otherwise, we have got multiple support available in terms of community as well. So it would be relatively easier for you to start the work over the previous conditions that we had. Now, what I'm going to do next is very simple. We have got other systems that are built And Open Vino is one topic that I wanted to definitely discuss. Before I tell you how exactly to install Open Vino and to go ahead with that, I want to show you the power of Open Vino. How do I show you the power? With a simple demo. I have built a system with Open Vino where you can see that we are able to determine the emotions of the people properly. The posture can be recognized and predicted properly. And Open Vino is from Intel, is a real powerful tool. I'll talk about it a little later. Give me a few minutes. I'll completely take you through the installation procedure, all these things, which are very clear demo. I'll do that. And before that, you see the capacity of Open Vino. Open Vino is really very cool, which is completely open source again. And you've got a lot of community support again. A lot of Intel innovators like me are working on it. And if you need any help, any sort of training, we can always provide you. Just see to this demo and understand the power of Open Vino before I go ahead with the next thing. Friends, I'm going to show you some wonderful demo with Open Vino tool that I have already taught you in my previous session. So I'm going to show you the post estimation app that is available there by default. So I have just installed it and I have tested it out. See the way it is working. Really, really phenomenal. And this is highly real time. And you would really love it. I'm going to show you two different examples. One is for post estimation and another one is for the emotion detection. So you can see that this is all real time. The moment I move, I make a movement, everything, this is all tracked. Absolutely stunning and absolutely real time. And you guys can test it out. And if you want any help, probably I can do that also. This is easy, simple, and very interesting. I'm going to show you the next one right now, which will be much more interesting. The only thing that you need to know is these commands are a bit long. So you need to really understand how exactly to interpret these commands. So I'll probably teach a session on how do we understand these commands. That itself is really challenging. So you are going to now see the emotion detection. I'm going to show you all my emotions right now. I'm neutral. I'm angry right now, they say. This is surprise, and you can see that, yeah, my eyes go up and this is surprise. And now I'm angry. All these are real time, and my age is reduced to here, 34. I'm happy about it. It is actually 36, but this is closely accurate. So this is all done with Open Vino, and this is very simple. So you guys can try it out. I hope you like this demo. Thank you very much for following the content and channel. If you have any questions, suggestions, inputs, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. And if you need any help, let me know. I can always do it. Thank you. Friends, I'm going to show you some wonderful. Well, it's time for us to understand completely how do we go ahead with Open Vino installation. What are all the things that we need to do for installation of the Open Vino? All those things are going to be discussed right now. I'm going to make it a very concise thing, and I'll answer the questions during the break. So I have answered a couple of questions quickly over there. So if you have questions, keep typing it. I'll get you the answers during the break. When I play video, I can probably answer your questions in between. But it's time for understanding Open Vino now. And after Open Vino, I'll show you one very cool demo that I have built recently, which I definitely like very much. So I'll show you that. And with that, probably it will be 11:30, 11:45, and we can go ahead with the Q&A where I can pick up your questions if you have any, and it's going to be ready. It's going to be very, very interesting. So Open Vino installation is very simple and very easy. I'll tell you the features. We have got a lot of features that are coming with Open Vino as a package. And do we need a high-end machine? Do we need a machine with so much of power? Not at all. You do not require that much. And you can work with any hardware from Intel. Say you have only Intel boards available like NUC or Intel boards available like Intel AI Vision Kit. You can still go ahead with it. But only thing is you need to have properly the requirements met in terms of software. That's a little complex over there. I'll explain you all that. And we are going to see how exactly Open Vino works. I'm going to just talk about the installation process. It's going to be a 10-minute presentation discussion, and then we'll see a couple of quick demos again, and we'll call it a day. Friends, hello friends. I'm going to talk about one of the most happening AI software tools, Open Vino. This is from Intel, and I'm going to show you some demos as well, which will help you understand how exactly this tool can be used for your projects and your innovations that we are planning to do. First of all, what is Open Vino? Open Vino is from Intel, and it is expanded as Open Visual Inference and Neural Network Optimization Toolkit. Open Visual Inference and Neural Network Optimization Toolkit. This is the fastest as of now for AI and computer vision applications, I could say. And earlier, it was named as Intel Computer Vision SDK. This has got improved neural network performance. To be very precise, this works on various Intel platforms and process. You can start with the laptop that I'm working right now, and it can go on till the neural compute stick, which I have shown the demo some time back. So OpenVINO is cost effective and most suitable for real-time computation applications. I'll show you a couple of demos, which will definitely be stunning, and they are absolutely real-time. There is no delay, and it's really fantastic. And this enables a deep learning inference as well as heterogeneous execution a reality. What do you mean by heterogeneous execution? You can run it on a laptop, you can run it on a desktop, you can run it on a neural compute stick, you can run it on the AI vision kit. Multiple platforms are really supported when you learn this software, and it's going to be really useful for you. And this can enable the developers to innovate with deep learning and AI solutions on the edge. Remember, AI solutions on the edge. One good thing is this is very easy to try, and I have learned it over just 1 or 2 days. I just tried things and it's all very easy. And this is compatible with Neural Compute Stick version 1 and version 2 as well. Well, the installation is a bit tricky, I should admit. But when you go through the steps properly, and if you do that, it's very easy. The only thing is don't miss any step. It has to be followed meticulously. We have got OpenVINO support for Linux, Windows 10 and Mac. I'm going to show you the demo in Windows 10 first, and in my next session, I'll show you the demo with Linux. This is pretty easy, and maximum in an hour, you can get everything done. There will not be any much errors, and the support for the errors also, I mean, the forums are also available, and you can just post it there, and you can get your queries answered. Like, people like us can really help you out there. I'm going to take you through the whole process for the Windows platform right now. But remember, I need a real good hardware requirement here. 6th gen to 8th gen Intel Core process is what I need. I have an Intel i7 8th gen, which I'm working right now with 16 GB RAM. And this is very fast and very good. And if you have anything above 6 or equivalent to 6 with a decent RAM capacity, I think this would do. Intel Xeon V5 works. Intel Xeon V6 family works. Movidius Neural Compute Stick version 1, Neural Compute Stick version 2. All this stuff works. And this is simply stunning. So where do we start it? We started with the link intelsoftware.intel.com en-us OpenVINO toolkit documentation get started. And you will get this website right in front of you. I'll show it to you right now. Where do you have it? So this is the website that I'm talking about. And this is how it will look like, software.intel.com. And there you get all this information clearly available. And you can see that there is a Windows button available here. You need to just click it. And the moment you click it, you will be taken through a clear guide. The guide is really well made, and people have put in a lot of effort there really to make it really nice. This is very, very good. So we are going to go through this step right now for installation of the OpenVINO for Windows. Right. The complete support is available in the link that I have shown you. But remember, I need to install 3 other support software for me to run the OpenVINO. So what are all the software that I got to install? First one is Microsoft Visual Studio with C++ 2019, 2017 or 2015. So I have got 2019 version installed, and you can go with the lower versions as well, whichever I have mentioned, and make sure you have got MS Build enabled there. CMake 3.4 or higher, Python 3.6.5 with the Python libraries, and it is 64-bit is what I require right now. Now, let us download the Visual Studio package first. And you can download it from visualstudio.microsoft.com/downloads. And when you go there, go for community, free download support is there. Whenever I teach this in the classes, I give them all the installables, but you got to download it once at least so that you can use it. And when you start installing Visual Studio, you will find that workloads, individual components, language packs, and installation locations available. Go to workloads, tick this mark, tick this universal Windows platform development, development with C++. You need to tick both this, and next, you need to go to individual components where you got to tick the C#, C++, C++, MS Build. MS Build is very important, without which things won't work. This is very important. Now click it, and that's all. You can start your installation process. Once the installation is done, you will have the Visual Studio ready with you. Now what is the next step? We need CMake. CMake is like God for us right now, because every time we cannot compile individual files one after another, and CMake really helps us out. So go to the location cmake.org/download. And in that, you need to download Windows Win64-X64 installer. And this is the latest version that is available. Just click it, and download will happen in maybe about 2 minutes is what it needs. It's a small file. And make sure that you add the CMake to the system path for all users. This is very important. And once this is done, it will take about 5 minutes for you to install and the process is complete. Now, the next thing to be done is go to the official Python site, and it is python.org, as you know. Go to the downloads there. And since I'm using the Windows version, I need to go with Windows x86-64 executable installer download. I download it, I installed it, and make sure the path is all added, without which things might not be really smooth. So you need to click this and get the path added. Now, all these are done, right? Now let's go into the software.intel.com, where you need to register and download the OpenVINO installables. Registration takes about 1 minute, where you need to just give your email ID and they will send you a key there which you can use it for your future references. Now, the moment you click this register and download, you will get a file by name w_openvino_toolkit_p, and there are multiple versions that have evolved over a period of time, and I'll show you the version I have right now with me. So this is the latest version that we have, 2019.1.148. This is the version that we have right now, and I have downloaded this on 14th of June 2019. So the versions get updated as and when possible, they are updating it. So this is the latest of versions that is available. You will get it downloaded first. Now, once you download it, the work doesn't stop there, and you've got a lot more to do actually. Just don't do much. Click next, 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 and make sure that you have all these ticks enabled, which says that your model optimizer, models, OpenCV, OpenVX support installed. That's it. You are enabling it to be installed so that you can run all the computer vision applications without any problem. And you know that machine learning and deep learning exercises will not be smooth without inferencing. And we have something called as model optimizer also, which is going to help us out in optimizing our models. So all these are to be installed as package, and you cannot ignore anything. Just tick this hallmark, without which things will be difficult for us. Now, once this is done, this message may come to you saying that CMake is not installed, Microsoft Visual Studio is not installed, Python 64 not installed. You should not get this message now, because we have already installed this and it should be very smooth without this messages. We have installed the support tools and everything is done right now. You are all set to go. Now, what is the next step to do? Once this is done and click next, we need to set up the environment variables, which is very, very important. How do we set the environment variables? That's it. We have a command here. We need to go to this path. They have given the bat files already available. Once the OpenVINO is installed, you've got the path program files x86, Intel that software tool, inside that software tools, OpenVINO bin. You need to go to this path, and there, once you give setup var/bat as command, you can see it here. I went to that path and I have given the setup var/bat, and that's all. All the environment variables are initialized, and this is mandatory, without which you cannot run the code. It will be a problem, and this is definitely mandatory. Now, what is the next step? We need to configure the model optimizer. Model optimizer has to be configured for at least one framework. We have got so many framework supports available here, which I'm going to show you right now. And if it is not configured, really it will be tough for us to compete and then to run the code with this tool. It is going to be very, very difficult. The completion might not be there. Now, model optimizer is a very key player, which will help you in inferencing. Inferencing happens on the trained model when the model is run through model optimizer. Remember, inferencing is happening on the trained model when the model is run through the model optimizer. Understand this, the pre-trained model, when we run through the model optimizer, the intermediate representation of the network is arrived with, and the intermediate representation is nothing but a pair of files which represent the whole model. The pair of files are XML and bin files, where XML will be generated that talks about the network topology, and the bin will be generated which talks about the weights and the biases binary data. Remember, model optimizer helps you in inferencing, and the inferencing happens on the trained model when it is run through the model optimizer. Once this is done, you will get two files generated. One file is XML file and another one is bin file. That's it, is what you need to know. And this mo.py is a command line tool which is located in the path that I'm highlighting here. C: program files, x86, Intel software tools, OpenVINO, deployment tools, and model optimizer. So remember, we have got support for all the leading frameworks. The support for frameworks include TensorFlow. You can see that Caffe, TensorFlow, MXNet, ONNX, Caldi. All these are supported. And you need to just install prerequisites _caffe.bat. Cafe will be installed. Install prerequisite tensorflow.bat. It will be installed. I'll probably show you one example right now so that you can understand how exactly things work. I can run it also for you, maybe if possible. Just wait for maybe half a minute so that we can run this through. I'm going to the path right now. So I'll just show you how exactly things work here. I am going to the path that I have mentioned sometime back, and I'm installing the prerequisites right now for the model optimizer. It is all very easy and it is not at all tough. I'm telling you, it will not take more than 5 minutes for you to complete this process. Now, I'm going to the model optimizer directory again. I will install all the framework support. I'm going to install the support and the prerequisite tools for Cafe. So I'm going to install it right now, and you can see that it is run. It will take just less than half a minute for installing everything. And this is mandatory. Otherwise, again, it's tough. As I told you sometime back, you need at least one of these tools to be set up properly. Otherwise, it will not be smooth for you. So I'm installing everything because I run a lot of code here. And I'll show you some demo also a little later. So it's mandatory for me to run all these. Now you can see that I have configured model optimizer clearly. Everything is all done. So the model optimizer is all set right now. The only thing that we got to do is I need to see if the installation is all proper. How do we check it? Very simple. We have to check it by running a demo. We have got a car's image. We have got an image like this. I can show you that. This is the car image that we have used in the entire process. I have trained for identifying and classifying this car from the set of data set that I have using this tool. And this car will be first classified as what it is using the first demo. And the second one will exactly identify what is it this way. So we are going to run this right now, and you will understand how much powerful this tool is really. So let me go to the path where the complete demos are already set. So I have navigated to the path right now. Now we will have to see if we are getting the classification done clearly for the image. It takes about 1 minute for you to get this result. And it is really, really nice for you to try it out the first time. You'll be very happy to see the complete results out here. It's easy. At the same time, the only thing that you need to do is follow all the steps as I told you meticulously. Otherwise, it will be a problem. It might not be really giving you the good results as you expect. And one thing that I would like to stress again, please make sure you have got a machine which can withstand this much strong code. This is really heavy code. So you need to have this machine strong with all the configuration that I have referred you. At least i6 is what we need. And see that we are getting the result. You can see that it is classified as a sports car, convertible, car wheel. All these are the classification that we have done, and the probability is also presented here. So now we are going to go with the next demo. I've got one more demo here that is going to just identify, and you will see that right now. It takes again 1 minute maximum for you to run it. It's really nice, and you guys will literally enjoy your machine learning and deep learning stuff in this tool. And it avoids most of the clumsy stuff, which is regarded as the toughest part in setting up the machine learning tools and deep learning tools. Now, this is very simple. Once you do it, it's all easy for you, and that's going to be very, very easy. Now, see that we will get the result right now in maybe 10, 15 seconds. First time, it could be slow. I'm telling you again, please take a little bit of time to understand the process. And in case you have any difficulty, you can ping me. I'll help you out. Or if I do not know, I'll probably refer and help you out. You got the result right in front of you. And this is a car, and this is black in color is what is identified. That's it. OpenVINO is simple. So that helps you out really in a great way. And I wish you guys try it out in your machine. And in case you have any doubts or queries or something, I can always help you out. And this is all simple. Now I'm going to show you one other example probably. I'll try it out right now. Right. I have shown you the other example with OpenVINO as well, where we have seen how do we understand the emotions and how do we predict the posture of anybody. I've come almost to the end of it. I've got one more demo that I can show you quickly that we have done recently, just before a few days I could do it. And that is nothing but dimension measurement. You must have seen the dimension measurement software is all available in the market, but This is something different, and we have done it in a slightly different way. Go through it, though I cannot reveal most of the technical details right now. I wish you have a look at it, and let me know your opinions.
Friends, in the previous session, where I demonstrated you the dimension measurement of some objects using deep learning, I took a pen drive, I took a key, and then we took a hard drive to measure the dimension. But it did not measure any complex objects or different structures like a cuboid or a cube or a square. So today we have done that, and it's working functionally phenomenal and fine. Also, we are able to export the data which we have measured to an Excel sheet real time, and this is all working very nice. I'm going to show you the demo of it right now so that you can understand how exactly it works. First, I have measured a pen drive's dimension right now. You can make a note of it if you wish to check it out later. And now I'm taking a car key. I have measured the length and the breadth of the same thing. It's almost 7. So similarly, I'll have to measure the breadth of it. I'm doing that right now, and you can see that the dimensions are all in centimeters. So it's 3.5, 3.6 centimeters. And the next one is going to be my hard drive. You can see that I'm measuring the length, and I'll go to the depth later. I mean the breadth later. You could see that we have got 11 there, and here you could see it is close to 8.1, 8.2 centimeters almost. So similarly, I'm going to take the next one, which is nothing but my remote. So you can see it is close to 14.5 centimeters length, and we need to now measure the breadth of it, and it is going to be somewhere close to 4. Right, now comes the real problem, where I'm going to take a different object altogether and I'm going to try it out. You can see that this is a box where we are measuring the dimension of it right now. You can see that it's 10 centimeters, almost 9.910 accurately. So the shape of it and size of it is the same in all sides. So just to verify and validate, we are taking it. There is a mild difference. You could see that it's almost 9.5 here. So now I'm taking a different object, which is yet another different thing. So 10.2, 10.3 is what the measurement is. And here it's measured other side as well to just get you a clarity of the measurement. And you can see the structure, it's different. Let's run it and let's try if our system is giving the output as expected. Now you could see that we have got the output of the pen drive predicted properly, and I'm just giving the name of the object so that it could be properly stored in the Excel sheet. That's the reason I have given the name there. And now it is a car key. So I'm giving the name as key. So that's all. The measurement is all going to the Excel sheet, which I'm updating right now in the backend. Now it's a drive. So you can see the measurement is just perfect. There is a mild parallax error that should be in the order of that. That is also in the order of millimeters. So it's not going to impact that much. And now it is going to be the remote. You can see that it's precise as well. Even the inner components, the keys are coming up very fine. And this is functionally working fine. Now we take that additional objects that we have measured this time newly. You can see that this box is now kept, and everything is very proper and real time. You can see that the dimensions are perfect. In fact, it is very precise, and I've just given the name to store it, as I told you earlier. Now let's take the final one, where we could test if it is also working fine. And yes, the moment I get it into the vicinity of the system, I mean the camera, this starts detecting, and this is all fine. So the white box is also detected fine. Now, where do we go further? We need to see if the data is all entered properly in the Excel sheet, right? I mean, the spreadsheet gets all this data real time, and that's what I'm going to show you right now, and you would be able to definitely understand it better. Now, you can see that all the data, the height and the width, everything is properly entered here, and this is going to be definitely a good solution for the industries which needs the measurement to be done real time as well as to record it. I hope you liked it. If you have any questions, suggestions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. And if you like the channel,
that's it. I'm almost done with it. I hope I have made your 45 minutes or 1 hour a bit interesting. And I have another presentation in the meeting which is left out by 11:45. So I need to get ready for that right now. And if you have any questions, you can ask me. So most of the questions I have answered right in the chat box, and I replied as well. And I have made a clear set of videos for machine learning and deep learning, NLP, IoT in my channel. So if you can, you can refer it. And for Intel related questions, you can always mail me. I'll be more than happy to answer them. And that's it for now. And thank you very much for the opportunity, Nihal. And I hope it was useful. Let me know if you have any questions. Probably you can type it out. I can type my channel detail in here once again so that you can go through it. Just give me 1 second. Right, I pasted it. Thank you very much. The audience are really nice, and there are a lot of very encouraging and interesting questions, particularly from people who are technically asking questions. They are really very nice, and that keeps me motivated to move further. There are many encouraging comments as well. Thank you very much, and stay safe. Love you all. I'd like to see you again, once again, at a nearby future.
Wonderful.
So you can reach me out anytime, Mr. Subramanian. No problem. We can help and we can collaborate. That's the purpose of the entire meeting. So I'm happy to collaborate with anybody out here. We can do that. I'm doing it with a lot many people already all over the country, and so we can do that. I'm a teacher fundamentally, so it's my part and parcel of my profile. So I can do that happily.
Wonderful, wonderful. Dr. Sriram, thank you very much. It was not just a very informative session. I think it also gave a lot of people the confidence, because you showed very clearly how certain things can be done and what the results were. And I specifically like that you're telling this is very simple. Don't get worried about it. Just try it. It'll work properly. So I actually see that a lot of people are getting quite excited. And in fact, I got some messages also saying that now even I want to try this out. So
I'll tell you something. If it is not simple, I would not have tried. That's the simple point. The only point that I always tell my children is to start is the toughest thing. Once you start, it gets going. The first step is to start. We can start. And once we do that, automatically things will fall in your place. And yeah, there will be challenges which we are ready to face, and we can have people to help us out. And there are people like us who can really help. And it's going to be easy after that. So I request all the participants to try it out first. If you fail to try, that's a problem. But if you fail after trying, there are chances to recover. This is my consistent statement that I always say.
Absolutely. And in fact, to all the participants, please don't get discouraged if you get stuck up somewhere, because it is actually when you get stuck up that you go deeper into the problem, and then you find
Absolutely.
You learn a lot more at that time.
Absolutely.
So always hope that your, you know, the entire path is not going to be seamless without any difficulties. Hope that there will be some challenges so that you will learn.
Right. More. I'll always tell you something. I have won about 55 plus hackathons all over the world. When I say that I have won 55 plus hackathon, I did not tell you how many did I lose. It's double the amount. So naturally, the amount of losses that you get, the amount of defeats that you get when you try something, that trains you. So whenever I get defeated by somebody else, I always get in touch with them, and we will naturally go ahead with learning something new. I'll share the PPT and everything over there to Nehal. Nehal will be able to circulate you. So Nehal ji, I'll send you the PPT of OpenVINO and whatever I could, and it will be reaching you properly on time.
Sure, sir. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So everybody, thank you so much for participating. Big thank you again to Dr. Sriram for taking so much time and effort to teach us about this. Big thank you to Intel for sponsoring this event. And a big thank you to Hugo from Creative District for putting this all together. And most of all, thank you to all of the participants for taking time out on a Saturday. I'll give you guys a quick update. Some of you I see have already participated in our Applied Singularity quiz, which happened when we launched the app. And in fact, many of you even won an Intel Neural Compute Stake or an NVIDIA Jetson Nano or Coursera courses, all of that. We're very happy to tell you that this year we have gotten the go-ahead from our sponsors to do more such quizzes. So the next quiz is coming up, most likely in March, we will be launching the next quiz.
So just guys, keep me updated on that. I'll circulate this to my student circle. I've got around 17,000 followers available with me.
Wonderful.
So I can spread this news.
Wonderful. We'll definitely share that. Sure. So we actually make sure that we get very geeky prizes. Of course, it's a very difficult quiz. It is not at all an easy quiz. And it is not things that you can very easily Google also. You have to kind of think through the answer.
I understand.
So guys, that is going to happen. For those of you who have not yet downloaded our app, please do so. You will get access to a lot more events like this, as well as courses, research papers, all of those things.
Will do.
So thank you all once again. Have a great weekend, and stay safe.
Thank you. Bye-bye. See you all.
Bye.